With just about 3 weeks left before elections here in Taiwan, in today's Taiwan Explained, I want to talk about opinion polls.
All right, you have 60 seconds to do that. You ready, Andrew?
I think so.
Go.
Let's start off with the rules. Now, here in Taiwan, there's a 10-day blackout on opinion polls before the elections, and that's long by international standards. Now, on one end of the spectrum, places like the US and the UK don't have blackouts. On the other end, places like China don't allow election opinion polls at all. Now, countries in the region with significant blackouts include not just Taiwan, but also South Korea, Indonesia, and Singapore. Now, during the 2016 election, several politicians and media outfits were fined for talking about opinion polls. That was a $500,000 fine, which is about $15,000 US at the time. So what do the polls say with just 3 weeks left? Let's have a look at what the lineup looks like on Wikipedia. They have a list of all the latest polls. You can see the incumbent Tsai Ing-wen in green has about 50% of the vote and a comfortable lead in all the polls in December. Now, the polls might not be reliable this year. Why is that? Well, that's because the main opposition candidate, Kaohsiung Mayor Han Kuo-yu from the KMT, was struggling in the polls, and he called on his supporters to lie to pollsters and say that Tsai was who they preferred as the candidate.
Very good. Just a few words there, right?
Just a few words over.
Okay, I have a couple questions for you, Andrew.
Sure.
So why do you think Taiwan is one of the countries with a long blackout for the polls?
Okay, well, the reason for these blackouts is because they want to make sure that the opinion polls don't have an effect on the election. Because I think in previous years, there have been claims that this has had an effect. And also because they're not really sure that these opinion polls are true or not. And there could be a couple concerns. It looks like your candidate is ahead in the polls, you might not vote.
Yeah. And since there's so many surveys going on, which sources do you recommend or do you like to go to?
Well, I don't want to recommend a specific pollster. What I would like to do is actually guide you towards some aggregators. So there are people who actually look at a lot of different ones. So the first one is News Lens. They have a fantastic interactive graphic that has a lot of different events from the election cycle. You can see on the left there, the Hong Kong protests begin. And you can drag that back and forth and see what the polls look like at different points during the campaign. Now, another site that I want to point you to is Frozen Garlic. Now, the name is interesting. It comes from the Taiwanese way to say, get Dong elected,
Dong Suan,
right? So this is actually by a political scientist, Nathan Bato, who's at Academia Sinica. He has some really interesting insight into whether Han Kuo-yu's ploy to ruin the opinion polls is working or not. I think you should read the whole article, and we'll actually post that article in the information below. But in essence, he says that Han might have increased the level of uncertainty a little bit about the polls, but the bad news for Han coming from the polls is pretty convincing.
Okay. Well, that's very interesting. Thank you very much, Andrew. And we'll have links to those sources below. And that's our Taiwan Explained for the week.